I'm going to demonstrate how to convert any single page application to a custom UI command extension. All you need to do is adding this configuration object to the package.json of the single page application. The example I'm going to use is Excalidraw. It's a very popular whiteboard app that you can use to draw nice diagrams like what I'm doing here. And you can select an object and export image. So that's what I want to convert. It's an open source project written in React. So let me clone it. By the way, this is just a demonstration to show how easy it is to convert an extension. It doesn't mean it is a good idea to use Excalidraw in an extension rather than in the web browser. Actually, I think it's more reasonable to just open a web browser and work on it because it's already very easy to use. But one limitation of Excalidraw is that you can only open one project at a time in the single browser. You can choose to pay for its Excalidraw Plus subscription, but if you convert Excalidraw into an extension and create a library of Excalidraw files, basically integration with the file system API, you can open and work on multiple Excalidraw projects at the same time, kind of like the popular Obsidian Excalidraw plugin. Each file is an individual Excalidraw project. Let me open this folder. The package manager is young, so let me install the dependencies first. The web app is in Excalidraw app. So let me cd into it and run. Actually, let me run yarn start first. This app is open on localhost 3000. Good. Let me start the conversion. The first step I recommend is adding this JSON schema to the package.json so you can see which properties are missing. So here I'm missing license. And I can add license. I'm missing the Kunkun config. Here I can see, more fields are missing. I'm just gonna copy some code here. So the error, the warning is gone. We need a name, we need an identifier, description, icon. There can be many types of icon. So iconify is the simplest. You can also use base64, a remote URL, SVG, or just text. I'm gonna use iconify here. We will need to add some permissions later, but it's empty for now. The custom UI commands is how you configure where to load the extension. The main field is the URL you want to load in production. So for example, the web app runs on the root route. So we use a single slash. The name is what will be shown in the command list. Dev main is the dev server URL, so we can get live reload, hot module replacements. And this is the folder that contains the front end. I will show you in a minute. Let me first add this extension with add dev extension. You can drag the folder to here or simply select the location. So it's here, open. If you see success, that means the package.json is valid and we can see it here. Here we have HMR, which is hot module replacement enabled. You can toggle it on and off. So if it's turned off, let me show you. You will see not found because we didn't build this app. So the build folder doesn't exist yet. If I toggle it on and load again, instead of loading from build folder, it will load from this URL. So we can see the web page. Yep, so this is how easy it is to convert a front-end application to Kunkun extension. Let me build it. After building, you will see the build folder and it contains index.html file. So this is a very typical single page application. Now, if I go back and toggle it off, This time it will load from the build folder, which is this file. Great. Now let me dive deeper. I will start the dev server again. During development, I recommend you go to settings and disable hide and blur. So when you focus on another application, this window doesn't hide. You can also right click to inspect elements or toggle DevTools to use a console. So you can use console log to debug. Let's look at the extension again. If I draw some diagram, you will see there's a button hidden behind this. You can see the three buttons floating on top of the extension. They're provided by default to give you some basic control over the window, so you can go back at least. Otherwise, without the go back button, you will need to programmatically trigger go back. And with this button, you can move the window around. After finish coding, you can always choose to disable these buttons, or you can also keep them. You can move their locations, for example. Let me go to, I need to first install the dependencies. So converting an extension doesn't even require you adding the API package, but to interact with the app, you will need the API package. Let me start again and import UI. Let me import UI from the package. UI is an API for an extension to interact with the UI of the app. I will import from UI custom. But this project has some problem locating sub-packages, so I will need to modify its tsconfig file to use bundler. Good. Now it works. Let me go to use effects, which is the onMount hook. I can call UI hide back button to hide this button. If you want to keep the button but in a different location, you can call show back button in the, for example, bottom right. So you can see it here. And it's blocking another button. So let's say we don't care how nice it looks. I just want to avoid blocking other buttons. So I will say bottom five. And right five. So it's moved here. Okay, it's good enough. Let's keep going. Now I want to export this diagram into a PNG, for example. I can select it and export, but you will see nothing. If you're in the browser, when you export a PNG, it's gonna show a dialog to ask where you want to save it and save to whatever location it tells it to save to. But here, the dialog feature is missing from the extension. So we need to add it ourselves. I already located the files. The files for saving an image is in the filesystem.ts file. It's in the bottom here, file save. It's calling this file save function, and we don't want it. I want to add some custom logic. We need the dialog and also the FS API from UI custom. But it's having some problems finding this again. Let me quickly modify its tsconfig file. It's another one. Save. Yep, the error is gone. Let's go back. The image data comes from blob, and it could be a promise. So the first step is to say blob data equals await blob. Oh, it has to be async. So let me first return dialog package.save. This will display a dialog to ask user where to save the PNG file. Pass and check if the pass exists. It could be undefined, or it could be null if the user cancel the dialog. Throw error and move it here. Make it the async function. The FS API has a write file. It has a write text file or a write file API. The write file API supports binary data. So it has to be uint 8 array. So I have to convert the data from blob to uint 8 array buffer to save to pass and bytes. Good. Let me also display some toast message. I didn't import it, but you can import it from the UI custom subpackage. Dot success. When there's an error, display an error. Let's try again. I expect some error related to permissions. Export PNG. And you can see we're missing the dialog all permission. Let me go back to, let's go back to the package.json. Yeah, this means to display a dialog, we need dialog all permission. That's very simple. We just add it here. After modifying the permission, we need to go back and reload. Let's try again, PNG. Now we can see the dialog. Let me save to desktop. I will call it rectangle.png. We're seeing another error because we don't have file system write permission to this pass. Let me copy it. Go back. By the way, the file system permissions are scoped. So if you type a string and look for fs, you will see nothing. Instead, you will need to use an object and use permission fs here, fs write. And you need to tell it where to write. The pass is, you can say this pass, but this absolute pass won't work on other people's computers. So you can change it to a pass alias like this. And other people may not be using rectangle.png, so you can use a wildcard to tell it to write anywhere under desktop. You can use a single star. Double means recursively. Okay, let's use a single star because we're writing to the desktop folder directly. Okay, let's go back and try again. Exports. PNG rectangle.png. Success. And let me open. Yep, it's here. Let me remove it and try again. Rectangle.png. Good, it's here. And by the way, the toast message doesn't require any permission because it's not sensitive. Good. Another example, we can also use open API from the UI custom package to open the file or folder. So let me open file. Just open the image pass. And it also requires a, it also requires the scoped permission. It's open file. Allow pass. Let's try again. Open Finder, remove the file. Export image, PNG, rectangle dot. By the way, since we used asterisk for wildcard here, so it doesn't have to be rectangle.png. I can just call it abc.png. And it saves and open the image. Good, it's easy, right?